Computer generated chess problem 2374 by Chessthetica. So all the activity seems to be concentrated in the lower right quadrant of the board. Black only has two pawns. White has a rook and knight. So obviously this game is won by white, isn't it? For instance, knight captures g3, a knight sacrifice, f captures g3, rook to e2, king to h3, rook to g2, king to h4, rook captures pawn, king to h5, king to f4, king to h6, king to f5, and you get the idea. In a few more moves, black will be checkmated. But is that the best way to proceed? There's actually a faster way, believe it or not. And I'll show you how. So, the knight still needs to be given up. But even more completely, with knight to f2, a full knight sacrifice, not exchanging for a pawn. And now here, if g captures f2, well then rook to f1, the king has to move to h3, unguarding the h1 square, so black can mate on h1. That's a mate in three moves. What if black sees this? And instead of g capturing the knight on f2, black plays g2. Well, knight to g4 check. The knight becomes useful here instead. The king is forced back to h3, and then white captures the pawn on f4. Black can promote to anything. The rook just captures it. The king can't move to h2 because it's guarded by that knight. There's only one move to h4, which allows rook to h1 mate. Alternatively, at this point, if instead of promoting the pawn, black had played king to h4, all white needs to do is play a rook to e6, and if the king moves back down to h3, rook to h6 mates. Notice how the pawn on g2 blocks the king's escape square. And if king to h5, rook to h6 mates because the rook is defended by the knight. So there really is nothing black can do. Even promoting allows rook to h6 mate. I hope you enjoyed this one. Until the next one.
Chessthetica's Book of Chess Constructs, Volumes 1 through 5. Available on Amazon.